Sup guys, it's Gamer321, aka Nigga2.
Yay!
Dude, what the f*** are you doing? That's not him, don't worry, that's my friend. I'm at my friend's house, you can just go over there. Yeah, just go back. There you go. What is going on guys? This is Gamer321 and I'm here to do a tips and tricks survival guide for Bronycon or any other convention that you're going to. I'm really doing this video just because I'm going with four other friends to Bronycon and I'm making this video for them so they can know what to do so we don't screw up. And this will also help other people that are going to Bronycon. But besides that, I'm doing a video vlog because it's just interesting and I saw other video vlogs of people doing tips on how to survive Comic-Con. So I'm gonna start to do my own and I don't know how it's gonna turn out. I don't know if my hair is lopsided, but I do need a haircut if you can't tell, blah. So I'm going to show you guys what you guys should bring, what you guys shouldn't bring, what you guys should do and shouldn't do, and what to expect at Bronycon. I haven't been there myself, but I've been to at least two conventions and I know what to expect. So number one is when you go on your plane or whatever like that, or if you're going by plane, pack lightly because you're probably gonna go to the convention and spend a bunch of money on all this stuff, and if it's too much to fit inside your luggage and you have to take your luggage on the plane, it's probably gonna be too heavy and you're gonna have to spend like extra money. So if you're going to Bronycon by plane, then pack lightly because if you don't pack lightly, you're gonna overpack and overstuff your luggage. If you are cosplaying, just bring your cosplay. If you're gonna cosplay for all the three nights, then you don't have to bring that many clothes. But I suggest you bring at least two pairs of clothes just in case you have to walk around with your friends or something. Pack all the necessities you need. Like you're gonna need to take showers. Because if you don't shower every day, you're going to stink, and the whole place is going to stink already. I don't even know if it does. It doesn't matter, but bring hygiene stuff like deodorant, bring a towel and, all the other stuff that you need. Wear deodorant, guys. I'm telling you, wear deodorant. If you don't, you're probably just going to stink just like the rest of the people around there. But if you wear deodorant, it should help. Over there in Baltimore, Maryland, where the convention is going to take place, it's going to be hot. So expect to sweat if you're going to be walking around. Tip number two is really a bunch of multiple things to bring. What you're gonna need to bring is a phone. You're gonna need to bring a phone charger, maybe an extra battery. You're gonna need to bring a camera, a charge camera. You don't want a dead camera, but bring a camera because you're gonna wanna take pictures. Bring a refillable water bottle and bring your own food. I'm not telling you to bring a bunch of stuff, just bring something like ramen.
Spicy meat.
It could be something simple like this. I know this isn't ramen, but you can just bring like some small thing. Because what I do with ramen, I crush it up, get the powder or whatever, dump it in there, and then shake it, and that's like a little snack. And you can eat it wherever you want. Don't bring like, Twinkie or something, because it's just gonna squish. So bring ramen, bring like a bag of chips or something, like hot Cheetos. And you can bring like a Gatorade. This could count as a refillable water bottle, but it really doesn't matter. And you're gonna wanna bring a pillow. I have this Rainbow Dash pillow that I got from BronyFest. It's really awesome, but bring your pillow because if you are gonna go to BronyCon with a bunch of friends and it's gonna be like five of you inside of a hotel room, that's probably not gonna be enough pillows for all of you. So bring at least one pillow and maybe like a blanket or something like that. Also, if you do go to a hotel, make sure you probably bring a sleeping bag or like an air mattress, like a single air mattress just for you, because a hotel is probably gonna hold like two beds and there's gonna be like four of you in a hotel. Not all of you are probably gonna wanna sleep on the bed. You're probably gonna wanna like have your own little space. So bring like a sleeping bag or an air mattress so you can have your own personal space. And for the convention, you're gonna wanna bring an energy drink because I think Bronycon goes on for all day really. So you're probably gonna want an energy drink for the raid party. You're gonna wanna rock around and all that other jazz. So make sure you have an energy drink or something. I don't know, bring a Monster. I have no idea. And it can't hurt to bring your favorite plushie. I mean, look at it. I mean, it's awesome. Like, I would love to bring this. I'm probably gonna bring it anyway. And one thing that I forgot to mention, bring a bag or something like this. I'm not sure what to call it, but this is my laptop bag. It's really open and crappy. But bring a backpack or like some type of bag like this. That way you can like put something on the hook and carry it around you, because you're not just gonna walk around there and look at all the merchandise, because if you look at all the merchandise, you're gonna buy some of it if you have the money and you're gonna need somewhere to carry it. I mean, it would suck to carry a bunch of stuff in your hand looking like some weird thing off of a movie. I really don't know what I'm saying. But bring a book bag or a backpack. If you're flying by plane, bring like a big luggage bag or something like that. Maybe you can like carry like a huge thing in your backpack and put it in as luggage to carry as a cargo. Or you can just like have like a carry-on bag that you can carry into the airplane. I don't really know. That just depends on how you're getting there. And that's pretty much all I got for the other ones, like what to bring, what not to bring and stuff. And I might miss something, and you can just check the description because I have a whole list of things that you should bring. Number three is just things that you need to be prepared. When you go to Bronycon, don't bring a credit card and expect to swipe everywhere, because I don't think there's like cash register things where you can just swipe your card and then just go. I mean, sometimes if you go to conventions, you'll see people out with their phone with a little thing, you swipe the card, you have to put in your number, it takes forever. So bring cash, preferably $1 bills, $5 bills, and $10 bills. Because if you go up to like $50 bills or $20 bills, there might not be change. So just bring some cash. Don't carry a bunch of money on you, you know. Maybe you can leave like your personal things at, you know, the hotel you're staying at, and then bring like a certain amount of money. On your first day at Bronycon, when you go into the merchandise room or the dealer's room or the wherever the room is to buy stuff, walk around there first and look around, because if you walk in there first and then you see something totally amazing and you buy it and you're happy, but then you walk around the corner again and you see something that you really want but you already have the thing you want, it's just cheaper, make sure you look around first and make sure you budget your money, because if you carry all of your money on the first day, you're probably going to spend it all. So I would suggest bringing maybe $50 to $100 on the first day. So if you're like banging with like thousands of dollars, only bring 100 or 200 and then, you know, just use that to spend on yourself, you know, to get like something that you absolutely want, and then the next day, just get your money the next day and then bring it and then buy the thing that you really want. So just make sure you budget your money, don't blow all your cash. And that's pretty much all I really had to say. I mean, any other thing that I have to say really is just extra stuff. Like, for example, if you are cosplaying, be prepared that it's going to be hot, because in Baltimore, Maryland, the temperature is going to be hot. So I suggest you bring a pair of shades, like this, or these, or something like this. Wait, something's missing. Now this is better, but I don't actually look like Final Scratch. I might not even wear this at all over there. Like, I expected for this wig to look a little better, but it looks totally weird on me. It's just eh. So that's pretty much all I had to say. I'm pretty sure I forgot like 50 other things I wanted to say, but if there's anything that I forgot, just check the description. Make sure you look at that list of things that you should or you should consider bringing. And that's really all I gotta say. Any last minute things, like since it's gonna be hot over there, maybe you should bring like some sunscreen because you don't want to sunburn or anything like that. And yeah, like I said, just check the description. But I really hope you like this vlog. I know it's different. I'm not good at these. Maybe I could like improve on them, but I really don't know what to do. I hope you liked the video. Please give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and peace out.
This is your captain speaking. We're coming into Equestria International, but before we land, we have to buzz the tower.
Lana.
Danger zone.